That was a whole ordeal. Yay!
Well,
it's,
I guess
it's the last.
Guess we're going.
It's the last half hour. Of 2016.
Hello, everybody.
This is Toxic Thoughts. To, salty thoughts for people by salty people, or whatever. I don't fucking know.
And this is a special podcast. We're here to say goodbye to what an awful year 2016 was. Can you agree? Can we all agree to that?
Worst year ever, by far.
Well, maybe 1940s were worse.
Well, for some people,
this ranks up here.
Yeah, for our generation,
it's worse to me.
Yes, this was our Holocaust.
Pretty much. And I really don't expect 2017 to be any better. So, hooray, a new year. New Yay. Year, new me. Which... Of course, Jesus. I really don't get the saying for that. A new year, new me. Just because it struck midnight, I'm still gonna be the same schmuck I was a minute ago. Because it's 2017. Jesus, it's obnoxious.
It's supposed to be.
Anyway, since this is a New Year special, what's the opening topic we should start off with? I got one.
All right, what you got?
Let's talk about all the crazy stuff that has happened this year that are bad. The bad stuff.
The Syrian war was pretty bad.
Okay. All the police shootings were bad this year.
Okay. So you want to talk about the police shootings? I'll talk about... How about this? I'll talk about this police shooting. In Weatherford, there was an officer that was trying to arrest someone. He pulled over somebody that had three occupants. One of them decided to hit him with a fucking flashlight because he had a warrant for his arrest. And he wasn't going to go to jail. Anyways... He was fighting, and his partner showed up for backup, and his partner apparently used a taser, and the taser didn't work. So he thought it was would be a really bright idea to use his handgun, to use his service pistol, and he ended up shooting both his partner and the suspect.
Oh, crap.
They're both in the hospital. They're both... The officer is in stable condition, and the as of this podcast, the suspect is in a quote-unquote guarded status.
Dang.
What do you guys think about
that?
When
I say police... Also, just to clarify, when I said police shootings, I meant the people blaming police for the shootings. Just to clarify that.
Oh, so you don't want to talk about this?
Well, we can still talk about it. I just don't want to look like, oh, I don't support police. I don't want to make it look like that.
It's clear that we are supportive of officers. It's okay. Just when no, an officer doesn't do his fucking job and shoots his partner, whether or not it's on accident or purpose, that's a clear lack of training. And it makes me question, how did you get hired onto the force in the first place?
Shoot. I'd like to question, what was the thought process in that?
Oh shit, the taser doesn't work. Even though I outnumber him 2-1, I should just pull out my gun.
Yeah.
I don't know what the thought process is. Maybe they'll come back and they'll say that, you know, he had a hold of the first officer's pistol. That would be the only scenario I'll be like, okay, well, maybe lethal force is used. But besides all that shit...
I mean, only thing I could think of is, like, he knew what... I mean, you obviously don't want to... You obviously don't think you're going to get in that situation, but only thing I could think of is maybe the officer who shot his partner... He's obviously going to shoot him somewhere where he's not going to die. Just instant. I mean, I'm trying to defend this guy, but I really don't have a reason to. That's just idiotic. As I'm talking, I really can't think of anything.
I think he was scared of conflict, of getting hurt. So he just wanted to take him out as fast as possible.
But do you know what causes that fear? A lack of training.
Lack of training?
Yeah, there you go. If he was properly trained, he'd know how to take down someone and put him in handcuffing procedures unarmed. I mean, you look at some of the other, you look at some of the big, the police departments, and they go over that shit. They'll go through that in depth. A lot of these other departments, they won't hardly ever cover that. They'll give you maybe 16 hours of arrest and control tactics, where some of the bigger departments will go over anywhere between 3 to 5 weeks.
Yeah.
I mean, that shit's important.
It's like also... Whenever a police officer pulls over someone, they have procedures on what they're supposed to do, and you walk up to a car or something like that. They can't just walk up to her because the person they pulled over could have a gun and just ready to shoot as soon as he gets to the door. So it's like they got to walk up a certain way, do certain stuff. But yeah, I don't think that police officer probably fully trained if he got scared.
If he got scared enough to risk shooting his partner, then yeah.
Yeah.
Especially when the other guy, apparently all he had was a flashlight.
Yeah, shoot. You got a gun and a taser. Take that guy out.
Outnumber him 2-1.
Yeah, and outnumber him 2. Yeah. Don't get me wrong. Flashlights can be a bitch if you use them right, but even so.
True. When you outnumber a guy 2-1, you got more advanced weapons than that guy does. There's really no reason for it.
If the taser doesn't work, you break out the pepper spray, and if the pepper spray don't work, you can break out the fucking baton.
And shoot, quickly pull out the pepper spray and aim towards his eyes. He'll go down screaming.
Here's my thought. Unless you're outnumbered, or the guy is 6'8" and 400 pounds, or he's got a knife or something more lethal, you don't really have to use your gun. Because once you pull that out, there's no going back.
Once you fire it, there's no going back.
No. I mean, once you escalate to using that amount of force, even if it's for intimidation, there's no going back, man. You can't de-escalate use of force. I mean, how's it going to look if you pull out your handgun and then all of a sudden you said, oh, well, this may be a little much, so you switch to your taser or something. Everything's recorded.
I feel like for police officers, handguns, the last... Plan C or something like that. Plan A is probably the pepper spray. What would you think? What would be the first thing police officer should do? If the person you pulled over wasn't cooperating or was supposed to go to jail but wasn't wanting to, like the dude with the flashlight, what would be the first thing police officer should pull out?
If he breaks out a fucking flashlight and he swings at me with it, what I would do is I'd use just your basic unarmed arrest and control tactics. He swings the flashlight. You could easily turn that around and get his ass on the ground. If you know what you're doing, it's not rocket science.
I would have said just pepper spray.
If you feel uncomfortable enough to grab him and take him down on the ground just then and there, you back up and you break out the spray, man, or you break out the taser. If the taser doesn't work, the other one most likely will. If that guy's on PCP, that might be a different story. But you shouldn't feel the need to shoot someone if all they got is a flashlight. Now, if the other two guys people in the vehicle decide to get out and start a fight, it's 3-on-1 and one of them has a weapon. I can validate that. But you know what? We don't know everything in the whole story, so we might have to follow up on this. But that's what I think. Now, you wanted to talk about something else, right?
Depends if you're going to bleep it out.
We'll just see, man. You know how it is. I'd like to have at least one episode where... We need to have one episode where there is no bleeps. At least one.
Quite a lot.
Another thing we could talk about that's gone terribly wrong this year is the clown outbreak that happened during Halloween.
Oh my god, I almost forgot about that.
Yeah, that's something we could talk about. But how the heck does that get started? some wacko people dressed up in clown costumes go around scaring people.
I have no idea. I think it was a prank. That someone did, like, I think a year or two ago, someone did, like, filmed a YouTube prank doing that, and I guess everybody just decided it looked fun.
Be a fucking copycat.
Yeah.
I personally think there was no clowns. I just think it was all prank or wasn't real. I mean, I don't know.
Yeah, I have no idea either, but it's stupid.
Of course.
People are dumb.
Of course, in the store, like, Halloween Town, apparently, like, I think that's a Halloween store or something like that. Apparently, clown costumes went up, like, 50% more.
Just for clown costumes?
Yeah, ever since the clown outbreak took out and it was during Halloween, clown costumes were the top seller. In bigger cities like New York and Chicago, you know. And apparently, I don't know how real it is, because you know how the thing that I think the clown thing is fake, because it's always, well, I heard from this guy and he heard from that guy that he saw a clown out there, like chainmail.
Come on, quick.
But
quick clowning around.
That dude dressed up in a clown costume's got to have some balls if he's going to come down here in Texas where we own guns and praise him dressed up as a clown. The heck's wrong with
there
you?
There was two college girls. They dressed up as a clown costume and they chased two 14-year-old girls from their middle school, and they ended up running into a store and they called the police, and the girls were charged with, I can't remember the exact charge, but the judge fined them $10,000.
Jesus Christ.
Dang.
Yeah. And they started crying and saying that, well, we're college students, we can't afford that. And she basically just told them, well, you should have thought about that before you did it. She did not cut them any slack on what they did.
Wow. I wouldn't have either.
Yeah, I applaud her for it.
God
that
dang.
Took some stones.
Of course, I just think the whole thing got out of hand, because you got to think schools were getting shut down. Like, I want to say some schools in Dallas were getting shut down because of clown threats.
Wait,
like,
they
elementary
really,
schools.
They really had lockdowns because of this?
Yeah. Like, they would either lock down or they would just shut the school out.
That's interesting.
School down.
Interesting.
Because apparently they would have clown sightings outside at the playground where the kids are at. The clowns would try to, like, get them.
Curse you.
Go over to where they're at.
Curse you, Tim Curry.
Yeah, pretty much. He's the scariest clown of all. he started it. I think he's the leader.
He did. You think this is like a secret cult?
Yes, he's the leader.
It's a secret cult of clowns.
God. But, yeah, this whole situation just got way out of hand. Of course, haven't heard anything about it ever since Halloween.
So let me ask you this, Panic. If you were working and a clown showed up out of nowhere at your place of business, what would you do?
Oh, shoot. Considering where I work at, we don't have any weapons in store. Well, maybe.
I would throw a crust at him.
Yeah. Throw it, crust on his head, then run away. Sticking on the clown topic, I actually saw a video. It was like a security camera, security footage. And it was like a dude going up to an ATM. And a clown was walking up next to him. It was during the whole clown fiasco. And the clown was walking up to him. He had an axe dragging up behind him. And the dude was like acting, oh, don't hurt me, don't hurt me, this and that. And then he ran over to his car, and the clown's, like, just kind of walking slowly towards him. And the dude got up to his truck, opened up the door, and, like, his huge dog came out and charged the clown took him to the ground.
What do people fucking expect?
Yeah, well, I mean, that's the fucking thing that gets me. Like, what do you expect? If you scare the hell out of someone and they go in to defend themselves out of fear, I mean, what did you think was going to happen?
You're just gonna run and be scared, I guess.
It wasn't like this dog went up to him and just looked at him. No, this dog charged him. It's like jumped up on him and took him down. I thought it was funny but cool at the same time. Like, that's loyal right there.
don't give a fuck. That's a good dog. That's a dog.
Mm-hmm.
And that's saying something, because I'm not much of an animal person. That dog just looks like
a dog. Would...
Like, he tastes like cotton candy.
It's the fact that, and maybe the dude, I mean, you can't hear anything, you just see the footage, and maybe the dude said, like, go get him or something like that, like, commanded him to go do it. Like, I'm being serious. It's like, what if that dog was trained? I mean, we don't know.
Yeah, but that's true.
All you can watch is just, my God, cat's meowing at me, but all you can see is...
What, are you having an attack? Him walking to the... Is that cat gonna maul a clown?
Hey, she does protect outside. She brings up dead things and leaves them in the hallway. She's killed rats before.
An offering.
Yeah. Are you proud of me? I left this disgusting thing right here in front of you to see. Yeah, cat, I'm proud of you.
So before we go any further, we need to come up with why Living and Redbeard decided not to join us for this very special podcast.
Redbeard is getting plastered for the new year.
He's getting plastered fucking... He's raiding and pillaging and shit is what he's doing.
Yeah, he's... He found a new town to go to and rape their women and... Drink their booze.
Oh my God, I wasn't going to go there, but okay, well, now that we're there.
And,
didn't you read his text?
Living is celebrating New Year's at a special fat girl strip club night.
That sounds about right. who's his favorite stripper?
Her name is Holly the Jolly.
Is that her stage name or real name?
That's her stage
name. It's on
name.
Her birth certificate.
Holly the... It goes off like this. Holly the Jolly. That's my stage name.
Her real name is Julie. Real name is Julie.
All right, that's pretty good.
Do you know Julie?
No, I don't, but it
just, I don't.
It just sounds good.
Last week we said Patricia was a fat girl's name.
Julie, Patricia.
I feel Tracy. Like I know a Patricia. I know a Tracy.
Tracy's not a fat girl's name. At least not that I know of. No.
Holly is definitely one.
Holly, yeah, Holly could be a fat girl's name, yeah. We're going to piss off a lot
now
of
we're...
people.
How dare you? Big Fat Polly's a fat guy name. Polly. Polly, Tony, Frankie, those are fat guy names.
Polly.
Pauline.
Big Fat Polly? How dare you?
Big Fat Pauline? That's a fat girl's name, right?
I guess. Pauline?
That's like a feminine version of Paul. Or
what Polly. About Susan?
Susan?
Is that a fat girl?
I can see it.
Jeez.
Susie the Doozy.
They call me Susie the Doozy.
How dare you?
Of course, the biggest fat name of them all. You want to know the big fat name?
The biggest.
This takes
one
the grand,
them.
The grand prize. Michelle.
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 Well, come on.
Oh, come on now. Oh,
come on.
Biggest fat girl you're ever going to see. Michelle Obama.
Ooh.
Ooh. Oh, man.
That's right. I guess the only good thing that's counting down 2016 is the fact that we got at least two more weeks before... Trump goes in the office.
You're very
and
you're,
kicks Obama out.
You're a solid Trump supporter, aren't you?
Yeah, I was a pretty much Trump supporter the whole way.
Can I ask you this?
Me too.
I need to ask you something, okay? Is there anything Trump would do that would make you no longer a Trump supporter?
I mean, I became a supporter whenever he... I mean, I even shared a fake video on Facebook about everything he was going to do in office, but if he pretty much did everything now as the exact opposite of what he was wanting to do, I would say I'd be pretty disappointed. Like, he wants to handle the illegal immigration thing, which I'm all for. Shoot, what else? He wants to pretty much get rid of everything Obama has done, which I'm definitely all for.
Yeah, I'm okay with at least some of that, I am.
I mean, just pretty much everything that he campaigned and said that he would do. If he didn't do the majority of those things, I'd be disappointed.
So there's not one thing he would do that, like, really, really piss you off? Like, I don't know. What if he outlawed the NFL? Which I know he won't do, but what if he did?
Then that would make me mad, because I'm a big NFL fan.
Would you become a Trump, you know, a Trump hater at that point?
That's kind of hard to say, but I mean,
you're trying to do everything that you can to make him hate Trump or consider it.
I'm just asking, what would it physically take?
What would it take?
I mean, I'm telling you, I mean, if he pretty much did the exact opposite of what he campaigned that he was going to do,
okay,
that would make me a Trump hater.
Okay.
Yep.
Because that's the biggest reason I became a supporter of him. I heard what he had to say. He understands America has problems, and that's what he went out for, and that's why I went and voted for him.
Okay. All right.
So if he didn't do... Yeah.
I mean, I will say this. While I might not necessarily be a Trump supporter, I'm certainly not a Hillary supporter by any stretch of the imagination.
That's true.
She is Satan incarnate, as far as I'm concerned.
That's another thing to talk about. Some bad
woman
that went wrong this 2016 is... you could consider this two things. The fact that people were wanting her as president, and the fact that after Trump clearly won, people are protesting.
That's what gets me. I don't understand how the fuck he could protest, you know, an election process. Get over it. You fucking lost.
And then they wanted to do, a recount, which cost thousands upon thousands of dollars to do. And it's not going to make a difference. Another thing that went wrong this year is that the fact that the media, maybe besides Fox News, because Fox News is pretty heavy conservative, or maybe not, but they're favored Republicans, but the media was so for Hillary. Like, they were the biggest butt kissers for Hillary Clinton, if I've ever seen it.
Oh, it was so funny.
Can you all agree to that?
Yeah.
The media was awful. CNN's probably the worst.
Well, that's why I watch the BBC. If I absolutely have to have my news dosage, I watch the BBC, man. And like, news nowadays has gotten like really, really bad. Like, it's so biased.
Yeah.
Even written articles, like, their titles can tell you that, you know, they have a fucking agenda, man.
Yeah.
Just any, like, you go on the internet and you, like, read any of the fucking news outlets or anything, there's almost always an agenda based on just the title alone. And it's so, there's no professionalism behind it. You know what? I'm going to look right now. I'm going to look on Google News, which, you know, puts all these fucking shit together. I'm going to read the first thing I see.
You know, when for her campaign they made her sound good, right?
Oh yeah, they did.
Yeah, and it's like they wanted to. They forget that everything Hillary has done this century. They want to look back 10 or 20 years ago at stupid stuff that Trump has said to his friends or something like that. No, let's forget about Benghazi and the email situation and plenty of more stuff. No, let's just forget about that. Let's go back 20 years later to what Trump has said. Shoot, if that were the case, none of us would have a job. And also, we got 4 minutes until it's a new year. Oh my god!
At least here in Central Time, yeah, you're correct.
To anyone listening to this in 2017, obviously it'll be 2017 when it gets uploaded, but are there flying cars yet? We should message Noble and ask him if there are flying cars yet.
Why do you think he would know?
Because he's ahead of us. It's 2017 over there. Right?
I'm sorry. I've done a little bit of drinking, so that can't. So I didn't. I really have to think about that one.
My God.
Shit. Okay, that's pretty good. That's good.
Okay, I did get a text from my uncle who lives in Georgia, and he did say, no, we don't have flying cars.
Did you actually text him that?
No. No.
Holy crap, that's funny.
Yeah, I said, Happy New Year, man. Y'all got them flying vehicles yet?
I don't know why, but you want to know what was one of the funnier things I've seen in 2016? That YouTube video of Hitler singing... He was singing to Call Me Maybe.
What?
Oh, in German?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I know.
Was it, like, actual footage?
No, it wasn't. Somebody, like, edited it to make it look like he was, like, from a movie. But it was really funny.
Probably the worst video I've seen this year in 2016 was the Meme Queen, which I still hate my you God. For oh, making dude. Me watch that.
It made me laugh just to make you watch that. It made me
smile. Ugh, it was awful.
Your torture pleases me.
It was awful. Because the number one thing, it had Hillary Clinton in it. Another thing, none of the jokes in there were funny at all.
I'm sorry.
I couldn't even watch it all. Too
dang for you?
Oh my God, yeah, I hate that. Yeah, it makes me want to throw up.
Oh shoot, guys, we got 2 minutes.
2 minutes.
2 minutes to live in 2016, then afterwards we could still bash about how a terrible year it was.
You know what? What other funny shit did you guys see in 2016?
I saw you graduate college.
Shut the fuck up.
A funny thing that happened this year is watching Hillary supporters cry.
Okay, that was pretty funny. I will say that. The meltdowns were hysterical. The amount of salt
was plenty of it.
So pleasing.
God. That day I went to Cisco after he won, like the morning afterwards. My God. The salt was for real.
Do you have to take your beach towel and sunglasses?
My God. There was some Mexican girl in there. She was like, I'm going to have to go back to Mexico now. And I was like, don't worry. I was like, don't worry. Mr. Trump will escort you there.
Oh.
Oh, that's funny.
An awful person.
I like that.
Probably one of the funniest memes I think I saw this year. It was the night of the election. All of us were playing. And cut that out.
What was that?
Payback, you were the one. Payback, you were the one that I shared it on Facebook.
Oh, it was like a picture of Donald Trump.
It was a big fat Mexican kid, and the saying was, "When you realize 2016 will be your last year in America," and he was like sad.
Oh my God!
Yeah, November 2016.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was funny.
God.
I'm not kidding. In college, I really did hear people say that they were afraid they were going to get deported.
God.
And I asked him, I was like, well, are you an American citizen? And they're like, yeah. So to that, I was like, well, what do you have to fucking worry about?
You can't deport every single Mexican-American here.
You can't deport.
They could deport illegal ones.
Yeah, well, he can't. He lacks the manpower to even do that, let's be honest. But
we'll see.
He can scare people to go away, which apparently is working.
That's
because
true.
People are terrified.
Is it the new
year?
I hate
to break up the stat meeting, but it's a new year!
It's a new year!
Oh my God!
Yeah, we're a minute into it.
Anyway.
We didn't even have a countdown.
No. We're unprepared, just like this podcast.
This is a fucking podcast. This is a fucking shit show. If you're listening in, I apologize from the bottom of my heart.
No, this podcast is good because we actually were bashing 2016 and everything about it.
Fuck
everyone that was part of it.
Fuck that shit.
All right, now it's in the past. Let's talk more crap about it.
Apologize.
Funny gonna wanna apologize.
One thing I am grateful for that never happened in 2016, I was grateful that Jeb Bush did not win the Republican nomination.
We already talked about Jeb Bush, though. He's like water. Which is a actual disservice to water.
Water is actually good.
Yeah,
drink.
Water doesn't deserve that amount of
Jeb
negative
Bush
criticism.
Is the water that has the food that you accidentally put in the sink still floating in it. That's what Jeb Bush is.
That's good.
You fucking dishwater?
Dishwater, there we go.
Please. Oh my god.
You know, it's just, I've said it before, but I tried to listen to what he had to say, and I was just like, ugh. None of the other candidates had any balls to really say what was wrong with America. I just can't, you know, and another bad thing that went on this year, I mean, I paid attention to the election because it's important.
Yeah.
Because I thought it was going to be a really important election, but people were watching it for entertainment.
Every election's important.
For entertainment. They were watching it for entertainment value.
They made it out like it was fucking drama. That kind of pissed me off.
Yeah. Yeah. And we can have the media to thank for that.
All they care about is ratings, man.
Yeah. I mean, we made a joke at work. It's like on the first debate for the president election. It's like they're going to have John Cena go out there and perform an opening act and then... Frickin' have a band and everything and smoke as they enter.
Or they should get, Steve Harvey.
Oh my god.
Hey, don't give
folks,
anybody any
your next
ideas.
President. Your next president is Hillary Clinton. Folks, I have to apologize. Oh man.
Hey, that's something that did happen this year. Steve Harvey screwing that up.
True. And he became famous because of it.
He became famous because he owned up to his mistake.
Alright, what was the deal? Like, he was doing a supermodel show or something like that, and he accidentally set the wrong winner?
Apparently. I didn't pay to... Payback, you probably know more about it than we do.
Yeah, he just read the card wrong. He said it's on the card... But they just told me, yada, yada, yada. I'm stupid.
Yeah, he told
me. I think I'm going to kill myself.
He didn't say that.
Hide your kids, hide your wife. Because I'm going to find them. What he said.
Hide your kids, hide your wife.
He did not say that shit.
Here's a topic idea. What's the best movie y'all seen this year?
Fuck, I don't know, man.
There's been some pretty good ones.
Those movies are pretty fucking good games. I can say that.
True. Yeah, but we're talking about movies first.
Alright, well,
we can do games second. Shoot. I gotta race it between Captain America, Civil War, Star Wars, Rogue One.
Hey, hold on.
I hated Civil War.
Someone's got a bone to pick.
What?
Yeah, somebody's got a bone to pick with Civil War, and it's not me.
What?
I watched it 3 days ago, and I hated it.
Wow. Like, I loved it.
I hate the actor for Captain America.
Oh, you do?
I cannot stand his face, his look, his character. I hate Captain America now because of him.
Oh my god.
I don't know. He ruined that movie for me. Everything else about the movie was great.
So I guess you were Team Iron Man?
Yes.
Don't worry, I was too.
Like through that movie, I was rooting for the Chinese. That's how much I hate Captain America.
Jesus,
my God!
There's no Chinese in the movie, but I'm still like, oh, I change, oh yeah.
I don't like all actors, and I don't see movies because that actor is in it. But me personally, I love Captain America: Civil War. I thought it was one of the best superhero movies.
Yeah, if he wasn't in it, it would have been great. It would have been up there with my top five of the year.
Toxic, I know you have a I know you're schmuck about Star Wars, but Rogue One was excellent.
Hey, well, it you know what? You know, great. Redbeard said that he had a bone to pick with Red One, but you know what? He's not here. He's out fucking pillaging shit.
You mean Rogue One? He had a bone to pick with that?
Yeah, he did.
Apparently on his Snapchat, he watched it and he said it was amazing.
Well, fuck, he said otherwise.
If you're a Star Wars fan, I don't know how you could hate that movie. It was just great. But I can't choose between those two movies because I just loved them. Those are my top two movies of the year.
The last movie I've seen was the last Star Wars in theaters, so I can't really tell you anything.
Shoot. Well, Payback, what was yours?
What was the last movie I saw in theaters?
Oh, if you've seen any movies this year, what was your favorite one?
Oh. Seinfeld.
No. God.
I'm trying to think. Put me on the spot. I'm not much of a movie watcher. The last one I saw in theaters was Jungle Book.
Jungle Book, was that good? It looked good.
Was that this year?
Yeah, it was pretty good. Yeah, it was this year. There's a bunch of movies next year that I want to see.
Oh yeah, next year's going to be a great year for movies.
What movies are coming out next year? Or this year, technically?
Guardians of the Galaxies.
Okay.
Oh shoot, yeah, this year.
Yeah,
Guardians of the Galaxies 1, Star Wars Episode 8.
Okay.
Shoot. I think the Justice League movie's coming out this year. I think.
Maybe. I don't know. I don't pay attention to
that. A movie called Logan, like the X-Men movie. It's just called Logan.
Are they doing
that looks
one
really
more,
good.
Are they doing one more with Hugh Jackman?
I think this is his last one.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay, that's why I heard.
And Patrick Stewart.
Damn,
I'm pretty
you
sure.
Know, X-Men's not going to be the same without them too, but I was going to say nobody's going to be able to play Wolverine like Hugh Jackman.
No. Hugh Jackman nails the role.
Like that's the guy.
Yeah. He is. But that movie, you watch the trailer, it does look pretty good. I can't wait to go see it. Shoot. I think they're coming out with a Slender Man movie this year.
Oh, shut the fuck up. There better not be. You shut the hell up. You're full of shit. You're just riling me up.
I think. Let me look up the movies that are coming out this year.
You trying to piss me off, you all. Fucking pissing about.
I'll be right back.
Fuck, now it's just you and me, Panic.
But, shoot.
I can tell you what movie was a real shitfest.
Assassin's Creed
was a shitfest.
Oh yeah, one more movie to add to my list, Spider-Man Homecoming.
Really?
That's gonna be really good. Yeah. I can't wait for that movie.
Like I said, I haven't been keeping up with movies because I don't watch movies.
Well, I guess I'm the only movie guy around here.
Yeah,
I mean, maybe
you're
Payback.
Essentially the only movie guy out of us three.
Wonder Woman's gonna be good. Actually, shoot, let me just read off the list. Guardians of the Galaxy 2, I already said that.
Okay.
Lego Batman, screw that.
Oh, fuck that.
Screw that. Spider-Man Homecoming.
To those who are listening, if you watch the Lego movie, if you watch any Lego movie, you've lost my respect. Go play with real Legos.
Yeah, seriously. Do what we did growing up.
Yeah,
go
fucking play
build
with Legos
something.
And then step on them. Scar your feet.
Okay, third one is Spider-Man Homecoming, so
okay.
I already said that.
Yep.
Justice League said that. Beauty and the Beast. Yeah,
that's
maybe.
I can already tell you, that should mean hype to high heaven.
It is.
Damn, Disney
it
fans.
Is, definitely.
You know what?
Thor. Thor Ragnarok.
All right.
I could go see that,
there's
yeah.
There's a lot of superhero movies.
Logan. Yes, definitely Logan. That's one I want to go see. Wonder Woman, I think that's going to be good.
Yeah.
This one might be a shocker, but I actually want to go see Kong Skull Island. I watched the preview to that, and it does look really good.
They're making another King Kong movie?
Yeah.
Huh. How
yeah.
about that?
Maybe Pirates of the Caribbean, maybe. I mean, after the first two, they kind of got stupid.
I think the third one was pretty damn stupid. I'm not gonna lie. I mean,
yeah, I watched it in theaters, and I was like, really?
It became too much of a fucking love story. I don't like love stories.
Yeah. Star Wars Episode 8, I already said that. Yeah, pretty much. Star Wars Episode 8, a new Alien movie.
No shit. Is it going to have
Power Rangers? I don't think so. It's supposed to have Michael Fassbender in there.
Oh, okay. All right. Okay.
But I'm not sure what the heck.
Well, Michael Fassbender's all right. I mean, that's the only guy that gave me real hope for the Assassin's Creed movie, but that turned out to be bullshit anyway.
We can, I can tell you this, though.
Well, what's up?
Go ahead.
I was going to say, I can tell you right now, I was looking at the Assassin's Creed movie, and I was like, this is going to be shit just because Ubisoft made Assassin's Creed shit. They ruined their own damn franchise. They don't need a movie to help with that.
Yeah.
But then I was like, you know what? Maybe Michael Fassbender can turn this around. But then, you know, the action movie came out, and I was like, wait a minute. This is a video game movie. It's going to be shit no matter what. So,
let me see. I already said Star Wars Aliens. Okay, Power Rangers, honestly, I don't know if you watched the trailer to it, but it looks promising. I won't go see it in theaters. I'll see it on DVD, but the new Power Rangers movie, that might be a shocker one, too.
Hey, there won't...
The Dark Tower.
Every fucking movie now has to have, like, a little, like, subtitle, doesn't it?
Yeah. The Dark Tower. I bet you that makes big money, because Dark Tower is a popular book series.
It's gonna have fucking edgy-ass fucking villains or some shit.
Yeah. My dad read the book, and he said... My dad, he read the book, and he said, like, the first two were, like, really good. And then, like, the rest of them just got weird. Ugh, can't believe this one's here, but Transformers The Last Knight.
I'm telling you, man. I'm telling you, man. They're gonna do a fucking twist, and they're gonna be like, guess what? We gotta go find Megatron. We gotta put him back together. He's gonna be our new hero now. He's gonna be our anti-hero. He's gotta go take on Optimus Prime. No, they did that.
I will go see it.
Hey, we talked about this, you know, a couple of days ago, but it kind of pisses me off how in the first movie Megatron was such a fucking badass, and he'd like beat the shit out of everybody.
Didn't do anything.
And then the next one, like, he got his ass kicked by fucking Optimus Prime. And then in the third one, he fucking kicks the shit out of Sentinel Prime, and then he gets his ass kicked by Optimus Prime again, but the only difference is that Optimus Prime has one fucking arm. Like, what the fuck? Like, Optimus Prime can't take on Sentinel Prime with two arms, but then all of a sudden you rip an arm off, and it's like, oh shit, he's a fucking badass now. I might want to see
people
in wheelchairs if that's the fucking logic I'm going to follow.
Anyway, these next two are going to be... real turd fest. 50 Shades Darker. Go ahead and tell you. Terrible.
Whoa.
50 Shades Darker. Yep. They're making a movie series out of the 50 Shades books.
You're fucking having a laugh.
This one's going to be. I'm not. I could send you the picture right now where you can look it up yourself. 50 Shades Darker 2017.
God damn. I cannot believe this thing.
I know. But the books were popular in the movie. Apparently the first movie made money, so why not make another one if it's gonna make money? Yep, it's awful. I would never watch those movies. John Wick Chapter 2.
I heard the never first watched one was the first actually one. Okay.
Never watched the first one.
I didn't watch it either, but I heard it was actually... I can respect Keanu Reeves for actually training with that. Have you seen like the little video where he does... Yeah, he actually did 3-gun competitions and like trained to use like actual firearms.
I actually didn't know that.
For John Wick. That's actually pretty cool. I'm cool with that. I can actually respect that because a lot of actors, they just use fucking props and shit.
Yeah. And whatnot. Or they'll have stunt devils.
Even for the, this is going to show my age, but way back in the day, like during the first Terminator, Arnold, in order to train how to use the Uzi without looking at it and, you know, like not having to fumble with it, he actually did have to handle like actual firearms. And that was considered like a real big fucking thing because most actors don't handle firearms at all. They're actually anti-gun. But Keanu Reeves for John Wick, he actually did 3-gun competitions. Like, not only did he like train, but he actually used the damn things. Like, you should look it up, man. It's pretty impressive.
Well, I can respect an actor who wants to go out for a movie.
Oh, yeah.
Where else am I on the list? Okay. This next movie I am very much hyped up to go see because I loved the first two, and that is War of the Planet of the Apes.
So it's War, what did we call it? It was
Dawn of the Planet of the Fall of the Apes.
Yeah, it was like War of the Rise of the Dawn of the Planet of the Apes. There we go.
Even though the titles are pretty out there, the movies are really good.
Yeah, the movies are good. The movies are good, yeah. They beat my
That's definitely a movie. Same here. They're better than what I thought they were going to be. That's definitely a movie I'm going to go see in theaters. Don't know about you. Shoot. Despicable Me 3.
I gotta fucking say that again. War of the Dawn of the Rise of the Planet of the Apes.
Despicable Me.
It reminds me of that fucking, like, childhood rhyme where it's like the bump on the log and the hole in the bottom of the sea.
Stewie.
Yeah. Well, it's before that, you know.
Shoot. If this movie isn't going to be edgy, I don't know what is. This is kind of title or to gamer tag you would see someone play Reaper on Overwatch in.
Oh, God.
Ghost in a Shell.
No. Don't you fucking dare make fun of that. Don't you dare make fun of Ghost in the Shell. You have no idea.
What?
No. Ghost in the Shell.
Explain to me. What is it?
Ghost in the Shell was the first American, like, animated movie, like the actual first adult animated movie to air, like, in the United States. Like, it was Japanese.
Really?
And it aired in 1997, and it was like an hour and 30 minutes long, and it was a fucking it's a cult classic, man. Ghost in the Shell.
Really?
Yeah, like, huh. Like, if you don't like anime, I'd say at least give this one a solid try, because it's really good.
Shoot.
But anyways, yeah, that's supposed to be like it's supposed to be like the action movie version of Ghost in,
live version.
Yeah,
of
it's gonna be a live action thing, and I really, really fucking hope they don't fuck it up, man. Like, I grew up watching that. I was 5 years old when I first saw that, and I really hope they don't fuck it up.
Well, shoot.
Yeah, you can make fun of the title all you want, but that fucking, that game is, that's not a game, but that movie is, like, I hold it dear to my heart. I really do.
That makes you so gay right now?
Shut the fuck up.
Let's see.
I was just kidding.
What else on this list?
No. Panic doesn't know about this. Panic, or Payback. They're making an action version of Ghost in the Shell.
I don't remember what Ghost in the Shell is.
It was that, anime from way back in the day. The movie.
The only anime I can think about is Heavy Metal.
No. Well, Heavy Metal's old, but I'm talking about the one that involves, like, the fucking the chick taking on the fucking walking tank.
Oh, the spider and she. Oh, okay.
Yeah, the spider.
So they're
tank,
making.
Yeah, they're making.
They're remaking that.
They're making a live action version of that. It's gonna have who's it gonna. It's gonna have I can't remember her fucking name. Panic. What? Who is it gonna be?
Well, here, let me click on it.
Yeah.
So it's gonna be a real movie.
Yeah.
It's supposed to have Scarlett Johansson.
Yeah, there we go. It's gonna have Scarlett Johansson play as the main character.
Better not fuck it up.
That's what I said.
I know which one you're talking about now. So
yeah. You see, Panic. Payback hates anime, and for him to say they better not fuck up Ghost in the Shell, you have to know that Ghost in the Shell is a good. That's a good thing. Don't fuck it up.
It is. It's pretty good.
I'm guessing she's a machine. She looks half naked, but
yeah.
I'm guessing she's a machine.
Yeah. Like, just about all law enforcement is like machine to some extent. Yeah. They're cybernetic to some extent.
Okay. Moving on the list.
All right.
Cars 3.
I saw the trailer for that. That looked more graphic than it should have.
Really? You want to explain?
Yeah, I haven't seen the trailer.
Like, he's it shows, like, an old... an old Lightning McQueen, like, racing, and all of a sudden, like, he's racing against, like, prototype cars from, like, the 24-hour Le Mans cars. You know what those are, like, Payback?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's racing against those on a NASCAR track, and I don't know if he blows out a tire or something, but it shows him, like, fucking wipe out and, like, do a couple of rolls, and I don't know, it may have just hit me wrong, but the thought of, like, live cars, like, losing parts and, like, having shit throw off on them, it was, like, pretty graphic to me, because I thought, in real life, if somebody was, like, thrown into a roll and, like, body parts start flying off of them, yeah, it'd be a little fucking disturbing.
Okay.
Yeah, that's pretty funny.
All these young kids are going to think that, too.
They're not going to think that. They're going to just think, oh, it's just a fucking car. But, you know, think about it, guys. Next time you trip, think about the possibility of your eyeballs falling out.
Anyway. I'll lose my bumper or a side panel.
Yeah.
Anyway.
You bump into someone.
Moving on.
Airbags go off.
Anyway, moving on. I heard the trailer was pretty bad. The Mummy.
Who was
the
original actor?
That's going to be a 2-hour film fest. Brandon Fraser.
Yeah, Brandon Fraser. He's fat now.
Yeah, he is.
He's fat as shit.
Bet you he is. He had to slim up for that movie. I bet you he was fat before The Mummy. He just had to get healthy.
Is he even going
to
be in the movie?
No, it's going to be Tom Cruise.
You see, that's why, well, Tom Cruise, really?
Yeah.
But yeah, the fucking franchise is gone just like Brandon Fraser's gone. It's all fat and fucking sweaty now.
It's like Roadhog,
fat
but a movie.
Sweaty.
Won't be shocked if I see directed by Roadhog.
You forget you're fucking you're gonna see the fucking rolls of film just fucking roll up. They're gonna need like an 18-wheeler to haul it up, and the whole movie you're just gonna hear,
you're in the middle of
it. You're gonna watch The Mummy. Oh. You'll be fucking, you're just sitting in the fucking theater and you'll be like, what's that smell? Someone didn't use their deodorant today.
It's coming
it's the movie.
The film.
Could someone please shut their mouth when they breathe, please?
You hear one, you have to say, I'm so sorry.
Got like a disclaimer before the video plays about smells. And it being too humid.
Sorry if you get sweaty in this film.
Alright, I do have a topic I want to talk about.
Alright.
Last night's fight with Ronda Rousey.
Oh my god, yes.
Man, she got torched.
She got fucking torched.
48 seconds.
Fuck up.
48 seconds.
She only threw 14 punches and only 7 made connection.
Are you... So, what?
Yeah. And the other girl threw... she threw 57 and 37 made contact or something.
Pod.
Is she coming up to
57 seconds?
Fucking...
Yeah.
Rhonda, what the fuck are you doing?
She's a wash-up sellout. Just... She's in the past. She needs to just let it die peacefully. Otherwise, it's going to drag her down, too.
I'm going to tell you this much. If I was going to fucking fight, I'd put up a hell of a more of a fight than that. Let me tell you.
When I watched the weigh-ins, just her face and the way she's just carrying herself, she lost it. She had already lost it before
she
even stepped in the ring.
Like right then and there.
I knew it. And just...
Well, what was she doing? Was she, like, smug, or was she just...
She's trying to have that tough face, like she's a badass, and usually the people that have that face or that mentality, they're the ones that go down. They don't put up a fight. And personally, I do not like Ronda Rousey. I have not liked her from the start. I have disliked her, so watching her lose made me smile.
It made the internet smile, too.
Yeah, I didn't like her because of the way she held herself, and, like... Through her whole career, she had, like, less than 5 minutes of, like, fight time. And it just kind of pissed me off how she fucking ruled the whole thing, and she was like such a bitch about all of it.
And everybody was saying that she's so attractive and everything. She's fucking ugly.
All right, well, I'll say this. Compared to, like, Cyborg, yeah, she's attractive. But Cyborg's a fucking man.
No, I think Cyborg and Ronda Rousey are on the same scale.
Are you? Really?
Yeah, I do.
That's interesting.
I think if Cyborg didn't take any steroids, she would be pretty attractive.
I'll come clean. I think Ronda Rousey's good looking.
Oh,
no. All right, we'll end the podcast here.